marriage in God's eyes, and the calling of God has seen you to know her as the sonship of this church.
Mother, Chuke, make up. Today is a very happy day for you. You remember the day two of you got baptized, Mr. Pastor Charlie? The speaker mentioned that this is a very important day, you should take note of that. So, in your diary of the day of remembrance, I should also add this day to it. It's a very good day, very good day to remember. It's good to have two of you this afternoon in this with this large audience witnessing between you for a Duke Maker and Sister Keziah Charlie. Well, the first day I had Brother Duke Maker mentioned Sister Keziah Charlie, I thought that was a nickname and you are talking to her. But suddenly, when I saw the spelling of the name, I really understood that was really, the information was very correct. So because I called you Keziah Charles, you remember? I don't know you, that was Charlie. We are happy to have two of you this afternoon for this marriage discourse. It's in order for your marriage to be successful, it's always good to have a viewpoint of Jehovah when it comes to successful marriage life. That is why the team says, honorable marriage in God's sight. Why do we have to look at marriage to be honorable in God's sight? It's because Jehovah is our creator. He's a happy God, and then he made arrangements of this wonderful occasion right from the beginning. When Jehovah created our first parent, Adam first, and then Adam was just alone in the Garden of Eden. And so Jehovah realized that for him being alone in the Garden of Eden, he needed a compliment, he needed someone to back him up so that they can make a beautiful place very interesting. So the arrangement of wedlock in marriage is come from Jehovah. And Jehovah wants wedlock to be happy, lasting, and successful. What can make two of you to be successful in your marriage is this reminders that contain in God's word. But as I said earlier, let's look at what the Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 2, verse 21 and 22. Let's see what Jehovah did right from the beginning. Restore your Bible to verses 21 and 22 of Genesis. So Jehovah caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of his ribs and then closed up the flesh over the place. And Jehovah God viewed the rib that he had taken from the man into a woman, and he brought her to the man. What a wonderful way Jehovah started marriage arrangement right from the beginning. You know, marriage is a very important in Jehovah's eyes. The Bible says that Jehovah made a deep sleep fell upon a man, and then he took out of his lips and then left a woman. What did Jehovah God do with this woman? In verse 22, the Bible says that Jehovah brought or took the woman and gave it to her. Verse 24, let's see what Jehovah did finally. He said, that is why a man will leave his father and his mother, and he will stick to his wife, and they will become one flesh. You are from Chukwuebuka. You have left your father and at this point, and then took Sister Keziah Charlie to be your wife. And she has left the father, left the mother, and everything with her, and becomes the girl wife. What happens to other family members of Sister Keziah Charlie? Those ones are what they call extended family members, because you have now established a family now between you and your husband. What a loving way to overcome is the marriage arrangement. And this marriage arrangement was to be permanent unions right from the beginning. That was why Jehovah made that arrangement and put Adam and Eve there to become husbands and wives. And today, two of you are beneficiary of this arrangement from Jehovah. Jehovah is a loving God. And so because everything he gives to us is something that makes us happy. One of the things he gave to us is this marital arrangement like this. I'm sure you are aware. And so in order for you, two of you, to have a successful, happy marriage life, you must take into consideration Jehovah's view of marriage. Jehovah's view of marriage is for marriage to last forever. To last forever. And that's why, right from the beginning, when he put Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, God instructed them that they should be forever as husbands and wives. For you, God has given Rebecca and Sarah Charlie to enjoy successful marriage. You must put Jehovah first in your marriage. You must stick to his advice. You must be willing to listen to what Jehovah says. You don't need to take advice from outside Jehovah's principles. You know, the Bible contains the principles that marriage should take. That will help them to have successful married life. Your marriage from today is like a twofold cord that will make two of you successful. You must be united together, support each other as husbands and wives. You know, there's this game that they used to play. I don't know the name, I'll describe it, you understand. Where they will have people on this side, and they will have people on this side. And they will have either something like a rope in between. So other people on this side will be holding each other wet. And this one will hold, this one will hold. Then they will draw it. There will be a drawing line where the person in the front will stand, and they will have to draw it. You know what happens when the other side wins? Yeah, the other side might feel weak. And then we'll be pulling from this side to pass the winning line. And it's people are shouting. If you turn your marriage to be on the side of the loser, you will not be successful. Your marriage must be strong, like the winning side. When they were struggling and finding difficult to separate, and that was what caused them to be. I'm sure you want your marriage to be successful. You must make it very strong and kind. You must trust Jehovah's advice in everything. You don't need to look for advice from people in the world. You know, everywhere, everywhere around you, you will see some places they call marriage counselors. Yeah, you see books here, you see there's some organization, they say marriage counselors, all over the places. This is the only marriage counselors we have. If you take any advice outside this advice from God's word, the Bible, your marriage is a kind of failure. So those ones, they just come with their own ideas. They build on what they have. Those ones are not the originator of marriage. The Jehovah being the originator of marriage and provide a clear advice contained in God's word, the Bible. He gives you the advice as the husband, he gives the wife advice too. So his advice must be strictly followed, far better than any marriage counselor anywhere in the world. So in order for two of you to derive maximum benefit from the advice contained in God's word, the Bible, two of you must study the Bible together, you must pray together, you must worship Jehovah together. This arrangement draws two of you together to Jehovah ever closer than any forms of relationship. I'm sure both of you want to be successful. You have gone a long way down to this day. Yes. You don't just say, make a child tomorrow and brother to the skin of body tomorrow. Is that what you do?
No.
You get to know each other. Yes. And from this moment, you get to know her more. She will get to know you more. So what? To be successful. To be successful. Marital advice in God's word, the Bible, is the key way to friends. I have given you a very clear overview of the beginning of marriage, of what two of you must do to make your marriage successful. Permit me now to draw attention to your personal relationship. What can you do as a husband to make your marriage successful? From this moment, Jehovah has appointed you to be the head of this family. Are you happy for this responsibility? You are now the head of our sister, to start a child. I think you are happy for him to be your head. Don't you? Very interesting. So now, as the head of the family, what does it involve to be the head? To be successful in your headship, you must use sound judgment. That's number one. And then that sound judgment was based in God's word, the Bible. You must be loving. You must be kind. In this way, you are laying a very good foundation of a successful marriage. As a head of the family, you are in a better position to provide for your wife, for your family, material, spiritually, emotional, and recreational needs. Before now, you might stay for 2 or 3 years. You don't know where they are selling new wares. You might decide to go for what you have. But from today, that level has changed. Because you ask, need to do this, I need to do that. I don't say, please, you don't know this is not my style. No, that style has stopped. That single lifestyle has stopped. You are now in the head of the family, over the wife that God has given to you. So you must make sure you satisfy her materially. What about spiritual needs? As the head, as the husband, as the head being an elder in the spiritual traditions, you know what it means to be part of a spiritual family. By now, you have been going around the condition, counseling family, to do personal study, to do family worship. You have done as well. Yes. So, you will know when to order to come and counsel you now. To remind you, what you can make up, please, have you studied this? Have you studied this with your wife? So, you must make sure that arrangement or spiritual arrangement is off. So, you are scheduled now as a single person who changed mind to a family. Yes. So, you must involve your wife. Your family, your story. And then you also need to provide out emotional needs. Emotional needs. Some people say women are very fragile. I don't think so, Sarah. Is this the truth? Are they fragile? To say no, yeah. Yes. If they are fragile, so you know how you'll be able to handle. You know what is on some things? When you handle glasses, maybe you want to sell something to somebody, and what the content is very fragile. What do they do? They say, please handle with care. Yes. So from today, the Bible says, please handle this like a challenge. That is our emotional needs. Women can cry a lot sometimes. Some things you can bear, they cannot bear it. So if she cried for something, don't say, why are you crying like a baby? Yeah, sometimes they are natural. They have to cry because something touched them so much. So be ready for four times to provide that. Before now, Morochuke Mecca, you don't like to go for recreation. Yes, you might not like to take some time off your business schedule to have a good time. But maybe Keziah Charlie is someone who likes it so much. So again, your level in this area have also changed. Yes, you must also be willing to provide that with recreational needs. And that way, can we go somewhere else today and just have a good time? That's not my style. You should be your style in Morochuke Mecca. We have to adjust to provide our educational needs. Yeah, because before now, children have educational needs, which you used to go. But if you develop your style, the man should be your style. You should also be able to provide that. That also shows that you are the head of the family. You must take the lead in worship as a family. Yeah. You have the spiritual person, just a spiritual person. So, two of you have joined together now as spiritual husband and wife. Continue to let that spirituality manifest to people in the congregations. Let that them see that visibility of spirituality in both of you. And you are the one to take the lead in this area. Christian leadership does not permit a man to be a tyrant. I'm sure you don't mean by tyrant. Purpose of others in the audience, visually define a tyrant person as someone who has a complete power and uses it in a cruel and unfair way. I feel like you want to use the sexual arrangements. Yeah, don't tell your wife, don't you know I'm the head of this family? I feel like it's a child. You know before now, she's the head of the family. Don't you? Yes. So you need to tell her that she's familiar with that. Yes. Even those who are not married knows that husband is the head of the family. So leave that expression. She knows. If the way you handle your sexual arrangements, should not be in a cruel or unfair way. Yes. Let's make sure that the way you handle your sexual arrangement reflects Christ-like qualities. To help you understand what it means to be the head in a Christ-like way, please turn your Bible to Ephesians chapter 5. In Ephesians chapter 5, please turn to verses 25, 28, and 29. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 28. I'm sure you are there. Yes, the Bible says, in the same way, husbands should love your wives as their own bodies. A man who loves his own wife loves himself. Verse 29. For no man ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cherishes it, just as the Christ does to the congregations. If you look at the footnotes in that verse 29, The Bible says fresh instead of boiling, say fresh. So, whether boiling or fresh, they are the same thing. So, you have your body, you have your fresh. And so, you cannot get your body, can you? And you take a pin and go spin your body and see if it's painful. Of course, when you spend it, yes. So, the way you cherish your body, the way you take care of your body, you want to make sure that everything is okay, any small pain, you are worried about it. The Bible says you do the same way to your wife. Look at verse 25, we escaped around. We say, husband, continue loving your wife, just as the Christ also loved the congregation and gave himself up for it. Are you sure you are willing to give your life up to it? Is that what you resolve to do? Take for example, maybe, you know, sometimes you need to hear some people have some kind of expression. They have some kind of jokes. It is supposed to be in a ship. Yes, by the ship. Your wife and someone else that also dear to you. And the ship is about to sink. And you have an opportunity to save only one person. Only one person. In addition to yourself. People used to ask, who would you save? And sometimes you hear the way people are answering. This one, answer, I will say this one, A lot of thoughts goes around. So, who will you see? I come to the fact the Bible says that Jesus Christ loved the congregation so much, up to the point that Jesus was willing, even give up his life for the congregation. And you are asked to follow Jesus Christ. So, from today, you have to follow Jesus Christ in taking care of your wife. Jesus gave himself up to the congregations. Unselfishly, Jesus put the interest of the congregations above himself. So are you willing to put the interest of sister, the sister Charlie, above yourself? Maybe sometimes, yeah, of course, you're here. But you don't decide to, you dress very well, you put on a nice tie, your appearance looks very good, and off you go, you want to go out. And to say to his daddy, come, myself. Your appearance is very nice. Please, can you change this life? This life does not match the shape of it. It's not good. But deep inside you, you look yourself in the mirror, that appearance, it's okay, it's very fine. So, what will you do? Go tell her, don't worry, that is my choice. Are you willing to sacrifice that your comfort at that time to satisfy that desires? Because in fact, when you dress up, go back at that point in time, you are dressing for who? She's going to be touching you and my husband is very fine, you look very smart. I love that. Yes, so if something you put on, she said also like, what will you do? You have to change. Yes. You are very comfortable with a particular lifestyle. Something you do. But from today, after this talk, when you go home, she told you, look, those things you used to do before, this one. Now I'm in your house, please, not your trust. Yes, you have to adjust. The way you used to talk when you were on the platform, I don't like you talking like this anymore. Yeah, because I want you to talk like this. Or imitate this one. And you said, I know, it's my style. Yes, it's my style. It's my style. It will be difficult for me to change. So, what are you doing now? Are you putting her into the head of it? She will be willing to adjust. I'm sure she's, there are some things that she's making say after today, you will see. Yeah, you will see. You will see for good because he wants you to make the marriage successful. So, Jesus was mild tempered. You have to be mild with your wife. You have to do everything to make sure you begin to find a sample of Jesus as he was leaving the congregation and gave himself up to us. There is no man in history ever hated himself. No man ever just walk close to a fire and put the leg inside it. I can't do that. No. So you don't do the same thing with Sister Charlie. In fact, look at what the Bible says in Colossians 3:19. In verse 19, the Bible says, you husbands, keep on loving your wives and do not be bitterly angry with them. Look at the footnotes of that expression, it said be harsh. So whether you are angry, whether you are happy, it's okay. a couple, the man was having a very good occasion. Yes. And he told the wife, please prepare something for us to eat. And my guests are coming. So they go from work, or then they go to the house, and the wife brings food to serve. The slave showed that the food was salty. Food was very salty. And so the people there, the guests were complaining. Say, ah, the food is salty, the food is salty. The worst part of the food was salty. But he told them, ah, look. And that is how we eat here. That my wife knew I like salt so much. That is why he made his food like that. He got us off when we visited us. He goes, that's why he let's eat. But you can make an out proud wife. So if the guests shut up and they enjoy the food. Yes. Because that is the man's style. That is what he wants. But was it really true? The man likes us? No! No. They were not doing that just to make sure you cover up the wife. So you don't bring anger in any angle. You don't bring anger in the husband's protecting her in that way. So you should make sure you bring sense to you. No angry with her in any way, outside, both inside or in manhole, in accessories, at the meetings or whatever. There are some big man that noticed from her that my mom also like. But now you don't stop your eye like that anymore. Today, you have made what I do to Kimaker to be your wedded husband. Am I right? Yes. What does the Bible have for you to make your marriage honorable in God's sight? You are going to play a very good role in this marriage. Your role is very, very important. Remember, at the beginning I mentioned it. When God saw that Adam needed a complement, and so the woman decided to create him for him. Yes, the Bible mentioned how Jehovah created him for Adam, and then assured them to be fruitful and become many and fill the earth. If you don't enjoy people, you will not be here. Yes. You see how you throw this stuff now? The bend, also bend, two of your hands are very close together. So that means you always have to practice what it means to have a close union that is honorable in your past life. So continue to be subjective to your husband. Is what I mean. I'm sure for you to get maker will not say, don't start the over again. Beauty was something like that. Even if it happened, that's not what the something you said to you. If he said, maybe something happened, for you to get maker say, no, from today I must have been to over here again, you come with me. We agree with you. No, that's not what the Bible says. But anything that is in line with Jehovah's principles, what the Bible says, subject yourself to your husband. And you choose him to be your husband. That nonsense that you are willing to take is a world sacrifice that Jehovah has done. That's what the Bible says, you should have deep respect for your husband. You should cooperate with him in everything. I say this, you say this. Yes, no, even we have to think of that kind of things. You know, even if your husband gets, if your husband makes a mistake, you know, sometimes, because he's a husband now, decisions in the family is the one to make. Yes. So maybe you make a contribution. There's a matter in the family, two of you sit down together and discuss. Don't tell your husband, you must follow what I said. No. You only. If you make that kind of expressions, you're not shooting the respect. You are willing to respect him and adjust to any circumstances. People in the world are not making that expression. I told you, if you are listening to me, it will not happen like this. Who told you it will not happen like that? You don't know. So you must be at all times willing. As a helper in the family, you quite understand what the Bible says about the capable one in the book of Proverbs. Let's look at your expression in that account of Proverbs. Let's look at your expression in that account. In Proverbs chapter 31. Chapter 31 of Proverbs. In your spare time, you read the whole verses 10 to 31. The Bible says, who can find a capable wife? Her value is far more than that of pearls. Her husband throws her from his heart, and he lacks nothing of value. But all you can make her, I found you today to be a capable wife. And that is why he chose you to be his wife. Because of that trust they have in you. Are you going to disappoint him? No. You're not disappointing at all. Don't do anything that will make you feel regret. You know, sometimes in the marriage relationship, some people say, I regret marrying you. Is that what you say? Is that what happens? No. No regret marrying you. Yes. Impossible to not regret marrying you. That is the expression of people in the world. Because the both have joined you together as husband and wife. Now look at verses 26 to 31. The battalion is on her throne. She watches over the activities of her household, and the bread of blessedness she does not eat. Her children rise up and declare her happy. Her husband raises up and praises her. There are many capable women, but you surpass them all. Charm may pause, beauty may be fleeting, but the woman who cares to cover with praise. Give her the rewards for what she does, and let her work praise her on the city gates. Are you willing to let her work praise the city gates? Are you willing to let God at you can praise you outside it? I'm not talking about your wife. My wife is like this. Why is this? Why is like this? For you can make her look up to your mother. Thank you, mother, for being capable. But will you be in a situation where the Matukimeka will hear other people praising their wives? The Matukimeka will go and say, oh, I wish my own is yours. You want to do like that? No. In fact, look at what the Bible says in verse 26. The first note in verse 26, you see, loving instructions, the law of royal law. So in everything you say, in your mouth, full with wisdom, your mouth full of instructions. Before now, people in the occasion look at you as a star, desire son and child. From today, that name has changed.
Yeah.
The Bible needs to keep on calling you the last time. Yeah, it's not a child. From today, that name has changed. Your name is Juan Chukwuma. Yes. So that is the way people will be calling you. Yes. And you're very proud of us. Yeah, I'm sister Chukwuma. In the congregation, we start Chukwuma. Some people call you start. It's not a child in the platform. When they come down, say, I'm not a start child. Some people understand. My name is Chukwuma. So you are very proud of that name. It's also made for Chukwuma proud of her. Anywhere she is, let her feel hungry to return back home to meet with your wife. Because of the way you are. Because of the way you keep your rules. Because of your friendly manner of thing. Anyway, he's very for now, but you can make a walk out, go everywhere. Any place the night come, just step up away and put his hands. Are you going to learn that from today?
No.
To have someone, that's what it is. So when the home is friendly, you'll be hungry to return back. Yes, if you walk tired, something anything happens, please, I'm going home. Because you are going to refresh yourself at home. But if your wife is not someone to refresh you, only thing of going back home, no, only time you come of going back home, you just say, think of what you are going to eat. That was just for men. When they are going home, they decide to branch somewhere to eat and drink. Because they know the home, they might go there is no food. I'm sure you will not keep your husband hungry, will you? Ah, yes. You cook delicious food. So that anywhere it is, you will not deceive the aroma of God. Yes. Nothing will make him find love for any food outside. Or find a love to come back and eat food. That is what it means, like a salary, to be a successful wife, a compliment, a helper to Baruch Kemeka. Every time, everything you do, look for him because of God. Decision begins. Before now, people can make a decision anyhow. Yes. Can make a decision to weigh anything. Nobody will talk to you. Even if they come to the conversation and talk to you, you also, next time, I repeat it again. The man is your husband. If you wear that thing, he tell you, say, please, remove it. I even say no, I like this. If your appearance is not fit be beaten, each time you are to be make a girl or ever's meeting, it has to be beaten. Because they will talk about it. Your wife is not dressing well. My job doesn't work. No, it's not that. Yes. Do you want him to have to be that? No. Please make him have feelings of peace. You cancel sister in the conversation. I know you are a very nice sister dressing very well. Do you imitate the style of the world? Live up to that dressing code. So I don't want to make that give a toss at the platform. They carry dress and grooming. People will turn and look at the wife. Speak from experience. when you want to come to the condition, he will speak with boldness. Not when Abuki Emeka is talking to Sister A. Sister A, at the end of his name, God, I don't finish. What about the wife? Yes. So Abuki Emeka has lost because of my wife. He will come back to me and say, what is in your place? He said, what happened? You are a cause. So let your everything about you. Yeah. It didn't happen to me in the midst of those who talk too much. From today, please. Let your words, systems of the soul, full of wisdom and instructions. People of God can come to you with confidence, with simple advice, because your husband is handicapped. What a befitting way that will make you feel happy. In this way, you as a wife contribute dearly, and two of you will have a very successful marriage. In order for both of you to continue having your marriage honorable in God's sight, both of you must be willing to clothe yourself with love. The Bible says, because love is the perfect bond of union. You know, sometimes some people say, when they want to get baptized, say, I don't want to get baptized at the sacred assembly. I want to get baptized at the regional convention. Why you get baptized at the regional convention and sacred assembly? Does the name change? So because you have a marriage talk in the kingdom of God, that does not automatically guarantee success in your marriage. The same way of those people, when you get baptized at sacred assembly or regional convention, that does not guarantee your salvation. You have to maintain your love for Jehovah down to the end. So getting marriage talk, listening to this advice right in the kingdom of God, does not guarantee success in your marriage. Both of you need to work hard to make your marriage honorable before you go. Root yourself with love. Let this love manifest in everything both of you do. As you are wearing a very nice for a good appearance now, you look very British, don't also. Yes, you take pictures today, you look at how you go again, you are smiling, you are looking very good, yes. You send to friends, people will come, you are very proud. You show them you are wearing pictures. As this appearance beautifies both of you, that is how love beautifies marriage. So let your love manifest, both of you, at every time. Look for ways to show love for each other at every time, to your mates. Show love to your mates. What you give a you are just last time. Set aside time every day to talk together, study together, pray together, cook together, and other things together. Yes. No, sometimes, like today for example, maybe Brother Jutuki Meka used to have a very different sleeping lifestyle. Very different sleeping lifestyle. Which is not well known to me. You know about it. But Jutuki Meka had a after all, one day she'll get to know this. So today now, after this set of everything, you go back home together. Is that what you do? Yes. Or are you going to be in separate ways? Go on. I'm sure the car you come together to be in separate car. Is that what you do? You'll be in one car now. Yes. So the same way too, you'll be together in the night. Maybe us two can make out a very nice sleeping style. Not known to you. So this sleeping style will disturb you in the night. Will you work your partner? What kind of nonsense is this? Who's that kind of thing? So, what kind of nonsense is this? That is. And was looking at the cancer, maybe the child also do the same thing. But well, most of us want to look at that. So, kind of, some men, maybe sometimes watch some movies, you see a man who wants to carry pillow, whatever, when the style is not comfortable, you don't carry pillow, and walk up to the skin room and just stand there and stay. Is that what you're going to do today? No. How things will be. So don't push her out to go and then look and teach her how you want things to be. That is God. She can also do the same thing. Yes. So two of you, everything you do together from this moment should be set locked as together as a man and wife. You don't have any problems in your marriage and you go and seek advice from a third party. Jehovah is your third party. party in your marriage today. And advert, and when you're not seeing face to face, when you see an advert, go somewhere in mind. To seek for that person. Don't run to parents. Don't run to father and mother. You need to not see this. Because the child will run to them and see that part. You say, when you go, next time you're not aware of this, you are this is how we do in those days. Some of those customs are not in the marriage. If you follow them, you are much before. You don't advance from God's one time. So something you see when other people do, what people do, that you like it. Try to practice it together as a couple. Don't do it separately. Don't go to the left, this one go to the right. You know, from tomorrow when you come to this kind of meeting, all they ask you to give your brothers start to be ready. Am I right? When they come to meeting, they will see who's going to sit first. Yeah, your wife will come to the people of Austria. I'm not going to speak in the person. Yes. Your wife will say to the phone and sit down front. He says, you've got to carry your back. And come to the back and put the other people there. People are rushing you. They will say, that is the thing that I'm reading that to you. Ah, pity them. Yes. Don't let people pity you outside. Don't do things outside that people will look and take pity about us. We can smoke them at home and come outside. Sister Keziah was telling your husband being an elder, you know, don't want to say yes and put your money to an elder. Remember, your conduct, your way of life can bring you down. Because before now, when you go to examine your future maker, they examine him as a stable person. You saw my apple. Yes. They said they want to talk about Solomon, they want to talk about Romoka, for example. Yes, when they talk about being finished, they'll talk about Shaman America. Let's look at the wife. Yeah, same thing will apply to one to make up from state. So, those are the goals of all that Kerala and that is the end there. Help him to reach out for what we do for service. That opens to Kerala. Don't do things that will make people feel. Each time you are to make up head of Kerala's meeting, you will not be set. Say me again, please, in the congregations. As a Christian husband and as a Christian wife, let everything show that you do everything. Don't give account of injuries. Yes, that's what you have to do. Don't give account of injuries. Everything you do must be according to this Bible. And please turn your Bible to 1 Corinthians 13. 1 Corinthians 13. 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 to 8. 1 Corinthians 13. Look at verses 4 to 8. The Bible says, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous. It does not brag. Does not get caught up, does not behave indecently, does not look for his own interest, does not become provoked, does not give account of injury, does not rejoice over unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Look at verse 8. Love never fails, but if there are gifts of prophecy, you'll be done away with. If there are tongues, there will be seeds. If there's knowledge, we don't have it. In fact, the Bible emphasizes law. Look at verse 13, it says, now, however, these three remain, faith, hope, love. But the greatest of these things is what? Love. What do you want to advise them to advise? To make your marriage for them. Which are these points? I will encourage one of you to please stand. I will turn attention now, as you stand in place, I would also like to see the later witnesses of this marriage also stand. Do you go to do Chuki later? In the presence of Jehovah, God, and his witnesses, take Sister Keziah son the child to be your wedded wife, to love and to cherish, in accordance with the divine law as outlined in the Holy Scriptures for Christian husband. For as long as you put my lead, you have a peace.
I do.
In the presence of Jehovah God and these witnesses, take Boradu Chukemeka to be your wedded husband, to love and to cherish, and deeply respect in accordance with divine law, as outlined in the Holy Scriptures, for Christian wives, for as long as you put my lead, you have a peace.
Yes, I do.
Wonderful. They want to take a marriage grammar. I brought them up here so that you can see them as taking a bath. So they will not take it from the bath, but they are intended to. Yes. So you listen to them. So I'll make some reading. You also read as I read. Don't make mistakes. I, nothing else. Jude took a maker.
I, Jude took a maker.
Take you. Keziah, son of Charlie.
Take you, Keziah, son of Charlie.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To love and to cherish.
And to cherish.
In accordance with the divine law.
In accordance with the divine law.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
For Christian husbands.
For Christian husbands.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Together on earth.
Together on earth.
According to God's marital
arrangement. According to God's marital arrangement.
Let's start with you. It's wonderful. Obviously, mine is already there. Very interesting. I, Keziah, son of Charlie.
I, Keziah, son of Charlie.
Take you, Jude, to Quebeca.
Take you, Jude, to Quebeca.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
And give respect.
And give respect.
In accordance with the divine law.
In accordance with the divine law.
Accept what in the Holy Scriptures.
As set forth in the Holy Scripture.
For Christian wives.
For Christian's wives.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Together on earth.
Together on earth.
According to God's marital arrangement.
According to God's marital arrangement.
Comes from above, a lovely gift called being in love. When two hearts begin to beat as one, then a wonderful time has begun. Oh, it's simple, so easy. And it's something we know with a threefold chord. Love will grow with Jehovah to guide us in all that we do. How I love to be truly in love with someone like you. Come our way, but our love will grow stronger today. We will build a bond that no one can break. We will build a love that no one will take. No, no, no one, no. It's simple, so easy. And it's something we know with a threefold chord. Love will grow with Jehovah to guide us in all that we do. How I love to be truly in love with someone like. As strong as death, you are bone of my bones, you are flesh of my flesh, such an excellent woman. In all that you do, I will spend
So
someone like you.
Someone like you. Nothing can destroy our love.
Nothing can
this
destroy.
Precious gift is from our God up above.
So thankful. Exclusive devotion, love's as strong as death. You are bone of my bones. You are flesh of my flesh. Such an excellent woman.